Hello guys!
Hello Julia.
Hi.
Do you know how Mavic Air was made?
I don't know. No.
Because Spark made love with Mavic Pro. Anyways guys, today we are at the DJI headquarters. And you know, Mavic Air was released yesterday, and today I'm gonna do a hands-on video of it. Guys, let's go! Yesterday, when I was watching the Mavic Air launch event, the host said it was as almost halfway as Mavic Pro. I thought, oh shit, this thing is gonna feel cheap and unstable. But now, I'm holding it. It feels not cheap at all. And actually, the flight performance is the best I've experienced so far. Guys, Sami here. Today, I'm going to bring you my view about Mavic Air. Though the design for me at first glance is not a big wow, it is elegant and unique when you saw it. It inherits the design language from the Mavic Pro and Spark, obviously. Here, I'm not gonna put every details about it, as you can either find more on DJI official site or from other YouTube reviewers. For me, I feel the whole thing is refined from Mavic series and more portable than Spark. It has a smaller size than Spark, almost the same size as Julia's small palm. It's foldable, the four hands, even the stand. You can even take off the joystick to save more space in your pocket. I was lucky enough to fly it in smart capture mode and record the app, which was projected on the big screen so you can see the drone and app reaction clearly. I flew DJI Spark before. To be honest, the hand gesture on Mavic Air is light years ahead of Spark. At least you now know exactly when the picture or video was taken. Overall, it feels more responsive, intuitive than Spark. Julia is the first time to fly it actually. She feels really excited about the new gesture controlling. Of course, for her now, a new perfect way to take a selfie. Though she has a little bit difficult to put it on, the engineers advise her to keep the palm vertical all the time. Okay, that's easy. What I want to say good things about the Mavic Air is the FlightAutonomy 2.0. It just merits more mentions, guys. Using advanced VUI technology, the powerful sensor system in FlightAutonomy 2, of course you can read that stuff on DJI official site. Here I show you how it works. You see, a good full throttle towards the obstacle. It keeps flying forward by avoiding the obstacle. Not like Mavic Pro or Phantom 4 just stops in front of the obstacle like an idiot. It's so powerful. The advanced pilot assistance systems, APS, allow aircraft to bypass obstacles in front of and behind it actively. You may wonder, can this APS feature be updated to Mavic Pro through firmware? No, it's a matter of hardware, the engineer said. Remember I did a video about Spark and I said don't buy it? But for the Mavic Air, guys, go for it, just buy it. This Mavic Air is the best drone I've ever experienced. And it's really, really cost effective. Only $800 you can get a $200 3-axis handheld gimbal, a $250 4K camera, and a $500 portable drone. Don't hesitate. Guys, please check the link in the description and see you in next videos.